NASA has sent shockwaves through the world of space travel by announcing that they may have launched a spacecraft capable of traveling faster than light. Einstein's theory of relativity states that nothing can travel faster than the speed of light, but this theory may have finally collapsed thanks to this invention. Let's take a closer look at this revolutionary new technology and what it means for the future of space exploration. For centuries, ever since we realized that every star we can see in the night sky is a sun just like our own, with its own solar system, planets, and possibly even life, humanity has dreamed of crossing the astronomical distances separating us from the ultimate alien destinations. Even the nearest star is more than 4 light years away, while the fastest speed a human-created spacecraft has ever traveled at, reached by NASA's Juno mission, is a mere 46 miles per second. Even at that speed, it would take more than 4,000 years to reach the nearest star. There are 2 limiting factors: the current limits of our technology and the laws of physics. Advances in fields like laser sails, nuclear propulsion, or producing and controlling either antimatter or dark matter could provide a game-changing technological breakthrough, but appear to lie far off in the distant future. But physics-defying technologies, despite being often touted as the future, are fundamentally flawed. To that end, if we want to get any far in the universe, we will need to drastically improve our propulsion technology. As it stands, our technological limitations prohibit us from traveling too far from Earth, let alone the solar system. Over the years, scientists have worked on many theories and prototypes that could replace traditional propulsion methods and help us travel at the speed of light. In 1676, by studying the motion of Jupiter's moon Io, Danish astronomer Ole Rømer calculated that light travels at a finite speed. 2 years later, building on data gathered by Rømer, Dutch mathematician and scientist Christian Huygens became the first person to attempt to determine the actual speed of light. Huygens came up with a figure of 131,000 miles per second, a number that isn't accurate by today's standards. We now know that the speed of light in the vacuum of empty space is about 186,282 miles per second, but his assessment showcased that light travels at an incredible speed. According to Albert Einstein's theory of special relativity, light travels so fast that, in a vacuum, nothing in the universe is capable of moving faster. Light exhibits both particle-like and wave-like characteristics, and can therefore be regarded as both a particle and a wave. This is known as wave-particle duality. If we look at light as a wave, then there are multiple reasons why certain waves can travel faster than white light in a medium. One such reason is that light travels through a medium. For instance, glass or water droplets. The different frequencies or colors of light travel at different speeds. The most obvious visual example of this occurs in rainbows, which typically have long, faster red wavelengths at the top and short, slower violet wavelengths at the bottom. When light travels through a vacuum, however, the same is not true. All light is a type of electromagnetic wave, and they all have the same speed in a vacuum. This means both radio waves and gamma rays have the same speed. So the only thing capable of traveling faster than the speed of light is, somewhat paradoxically, light itself, although only when not in the vacuum of space. Of note, regardless of the medium, the light will never exceed its maximum speed of 186,282 miles per second. Scientists believe that there is something else to consider when discussing things moving faster than the speed of light. There are parts of the universe that are expanding away from us faster than the speed of light because space-time is expanding. For example, the Hubble Space Telescope recently spotted 12.9-billion-year-old light from a distant star known as Arendelle. But because the universe is expanding at every point, Arendelle is moving away from Earth and has been since its formation, so the galaxy is now 28 billion light-years away from Earth. In this case, space-time is expanding, but the material in space-time is still traveling within the bounds of light speed. For every action, there is a reaction. That is the principle on which all space rockets operate, blasting propellant in one direction to travel in the other. But one NASA engineer believes he could take us to the stars without any propellant at all. Designed by David Burns at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center in Alabama, the helical engine exploits mass-altering effects known to occur at near-light speed. It has been met with skepticism from some quarters, but Burns believes his concept is worth pursuing. To get to grips with the principle of Burns' engine, picture a box on a frictionless surface. Inside that box is a rod, along which a ring can slide. If a spring inside the box gives the ring a push, the ring will slide along the rod one way, while the box will recoil in the other. When the ring reaches the end of the box, it will bounce backward, and the box's recoil direction will switch too. This is action-reaction, also known as Newton's third law of motion, and in normal circumstances, it restricts the box from wiggling back and forth. But, Burns asks, what if the ring's mass is much greater when it slides in one direction than the other? Then it would give the box a greater kick at one end than the other. Action would exceed reaction and the box would accelerate forwards. This mass change isn't prohibited by physics. Einstein's theory of special relativity says that objects gain mass as they are driven towards the speed of light, an effect that must be accounted for in particle accelerators. A simplistic implementation of Burns' concept would be to replace the ring with a circular particle accelerator in which ions are swiftly accelerated to relativistic speed during one stroke and decelerated during the other. But Burns thinks it would make more sense to ditch the box and rod and employ the particle accelerator for the lateral as well as the circular movement, in which case the accelerator would need to be shaped like a helix. It would also need to be big, some 200 meters long and 12 meters in diameter, and powerful, requiring 165 megawatts of power to generate just 1 newton of thrust, which is about the same force you use to type on a keyboard. For that reason, the engine would only be able to reach meaningful speeds in the frictionless environment of space. Burns states that the engine itself would be able to get to 99% of the speed of light if you had enough time and power. Propellantless proposals aren't new. In the late 1970s, Robert Cook, a U.S. inventor, patented an engine that supposedly converted centrifugal force into linear motion. Then, in the early 2000s, British inventor Roger Scheuer proposed the M-drive, which he claimed could convert trapped microwaves into thrust. Neither concept has been successfully demonstrated, and both are widely assumed to be impossible due to violation of the conservation of momentum, a core physical law. Scientists who previously performed tests on the M-drive believe the helical engine will probably suffer the same problem. Burns has worked on his design in private, without any sponsorship from NASA, and he admits his concept is massively inefficient. However, he says there is potential to harvest much of the energy that the accelerator loses in heat and radiation. He also suggests ways that momentum could be conserved, such as in the spin of accelerated ions. Even though failures of the M-drive and cold fusion are fresh in memory, Burns states that he is prepared to be embarrassed if his design fails, but the possibility of inventing something that could change history is far more exciting. However, this is not the first time someone has tried to reinvent the way we look at space travel. A talented research team at NASA's Johnson Space Center sent shockwaves through the scientific community when they reached a milestone that was initially thought to be impossible by many experts. Upon formal publication, their report stated that they had experimental evidence for an electromagnetic propulsion system that could power spacecraft through a void without using any kind of propellant as fuel. The findings stated that the electromagnetic drive, or M-drive, could convert electricity into thrust by simply bouncing around microwaves in a closed cavity. Theoretically speaking, such a lightweight engine could one day be used to send a spacecraft to the surface of Mars in just 70 days. The one thing that stands in the way of this new engine and the reason why the idea is called so controversial is that the M-drive seems to defy the laws of classical physics. As a result, even if the engine does what the team claims, scientists are still in the dark about how it works. This has caused the subject to be steeped in skepticism, with many physicists referring to the idea of an M-drive as the realm of pseudoscience. If an M-drive moves forward without expelling anything from the rear, there is a clear lack of an opposing force that would explain the thrust. This proposition is similar to arguing that a person inside a car could cause it to propel forward by repeatedly hitting the steering wheel. Another example would be that of a crew of a spaceship being able to fly the craft simply by pushing on the walls. The theory was first tested in 2014 when a team from EagleWorks announced their early test results, which suggested that the M engine worked. Since that initial discovery, the group has regularly tested the M drive at more stringent conditions in an attempt to further confirm the theory. Other groups have also followed with the development and testing of various incarnations of the engine. In addition to the experiments performed by US, European, and Chinese academics, there is also a community of independent individuals who regularly make and test their impossible physics engines. However, no one so far has been able to conclude that a drive has worked as intended. The current way that we measure speed is the distance over time. To travel at light speed, or 186,000 miles per second, you would need to accelerate past that velocity until your speed was 186,000 MPs, then hold it there for an infinite amount of time. This velocity is referred to as C and was defined by Albert Einstein in his theory of special relativity. We haven't yet reached what most consider to be light speed, although many experiments and theories suggest that we may one day be able to approach it or even surpass it within our lifetimes. Until very recently, it has been generally accepted that nothing in our current state of technology could even begin to move at a velocity close to what we consider light speed. Some estimates place us thousands or even tens of thousands of years away from ever reaching it. That being said, we are often surprised by what science and technology can accomplish, and scientists have now managed to make an engine capable of reaching a mere 10% of light speed, defying these previously held assumptions about what is possible for our technological capabilities in today's day and age. The invention of an engine that could reach such high speeds would allow us to travel through space much more efficiently than before. If you like this video, you may also enjoy this one, which talks about NASA's warning of a huge object in space that is sending radio messages toward the Earth. Do you think humanity will one day become a multiplanetary species? Please share your thoughts in the comments section below.